All right. We're still in Asgard. In Assassin's Creed Valhalla, so we need to bounce out of here. And go back to the real world. After I check my bag. Is 900, like, the max that I can be? For materials? Because that kind of sucks if that's the case. Did I say I wanted that? No, that's heavy resistance. I don't need that. I don't really need fire buildup either. But I kind of want that way of the bear. Ah, we could save that until I figure out what I'm gonna do. Fire, cool, fire buildup. Health, you know, I'm actually not too concerned about my health. I'm not. I don't know what range damage is supposed to do for me, or if it just means, like, bow. If that is just tied to the bow. I'm gonna assume it's tied to the bow. Yeah, we'll get it anyway. We'll get it anyway. Fucking helmet. Okay. See, the reason why I'm saying it is because, like, I feel like I haven't gone up in leather for the 900, but I'm waiting to get 900 iron ore to get my next ration upgrade. So I'm hoping that there's not a limit. I didn't even wake up. I need to wake up. Wake up! Okay, now we can actually head to Bossum. We might do the synchronization points, though, before we talk to Bossum, just so you know. We didn't do that yesterday because I got distracted with all the Asgard stuff. But I wanted to make it to where I knew that whatever I had left in Asgard was just stuff that I could do off-stream. And honestly, Tim, since I didn't know what time the baseball game that you talked about going to today was, I thought that you would miss stream. I thought you were gonna miss it. Well, there's no good way to go about it, so I guess we'll just start down here. We'll just start down there. Get those synchronization points and move on. Hey, yeah, the fact that it's talking about weak points with the bow, I think I've hit like 3 weak points in the entire time I've played with the bow. It was 110. And with the new pitch clock rule, it goes fast. What? Oh my god, really? Just as I start stream? This is your second time that you've done this to me? I hate you? What's the new pitch clock rule? Does it just, like, make the in-between a little faster? Like, the batter can't fuck around getting to the... Okay, so is it the batter that can't fuck around at the plate? Or is it just... focused on what the pitcher's doing. I know it says pitch clock, but I can still ask. Sorry. Fucking Nanami the Third's bitching, so. Alright, we're ready. We were totally hidden the entire time.
Oh, 1,000 meters!
There's 20 seconds between pitches and it puts both the patter on notice. Okay. Okay, so yeah. So, ooh, that looked a little weird, but we won't worry about it. That's nice, though. That it technically puts the pressure on both, because it definitely seemed like it, depending on the situation and who was up there, it's like the few times that I've seen and actually paid attention to the game 100% of the time, it definitely seemed like it was the batter and the pitcher that were both kind of the ones that decided on the pace of moving the game. So that's nice. I mean, like, it's not nice because you spend less time drinking and eating and just chilling at a baseball game. But it's nice that you don't have longer parts of just nothing happening, because I don't know if they're just trying to psych the other out or what, but it's like, it doesn't do anything. Sure. Land of Plenty. Sure it is. Whoa. Well, we already found a... We already found a temple that we could do later, that we'll be doing on Saturday. Alright, I'm gonna veer us off course. Straight shot! Yeah, because honestly, I never really had too much of an issue with the games myself. But I also haven't been to as many baseball games as others. I enjoy them when I'm able to go. And, you know, never- Okay, come on, Eivor, what the fuck? I can't say I, like, never thought that I would have enjoyed it, but I know I never cared about watching baseball when it was on the TV. And nowadays, I really just don't care about watching sporting events either. And yet, you get me in the actual stadium for a baseball game and kinda like it. Kinda like it! Okay, there's a hay bale there. Whee! The way the rabbit looks at us. You're exactly right. I'm fixing it for you, don't worry. Find it makes it worse for the in-person attendees, because it goes faster and ultimately the league thought it would help bring in casual viewers, but you're still on the fence. Person, it's way better and more enjoyable to watch in person. Yes! That I can for sure 100% say that it is way better to watch in person. Didn't Zealot appear over here before somewhere else? No? Okay, well, hey guys, we have one to beat up on our way to the synchronization. Let's go. I definitely see why. I can definitely see why they would want to try to help bring in more of an audience, but sometimes it doesn't affect them the way that they want it to. And having people out of your stadium faster definitely doesn't seem like the correct thing to do.
Yeah.
Okay. You're also still on the phone. Twitch app cancels out your autocorrect, so your spelling is worse than normal. No, Tim. Just own up to it. Just say that you don't. I mean, like, you technically did say it in that way, that you rely on autocorrect to help you with your words.
Won't be gentle if they spot me.
Yeah, I know. Our helmet didn't stay on very long, guys. Because we got spotted right away, but I want to go through the town. Want to make sure there's no flighting. I don't think there's any here, though. No, not in town. Alright, back to focusing on the main target here. I love that our hood completely contains the rabbit helmet. It's pretty good. There. They extended a lot. Oh. Oh, so you mean like... What you mean by extending their cells is you basically mean that they're able to sell it longer before the end of the game. Hey man, what's up?
I will crush you.
Oh, you're a little strong. But I think we'll be okay. I don't want to... Okay, that was a little different than what I thought was going to happen. I thought he was getting ready to throw mud at me. To be perfectly honest. I thought that's what he was getting ready to do. Aw, come on. Sure. Sure!
Can't stop me!
There's something. Oh, give me help. Yeah, how's that feel, dick? Ooh, you throw things. Hey! I see you getting ready. Oh my god, you're throwing again! Can you stop? Can you stop? Can you stop? Alright, we missed. Not bad. Didn't miss that time. Suck a dick. I win. Oh, of course. our team is one of them, so... Hey, that's pretty good. I mean, that's a smart move. If you know your games are going to last shorter, you might as well just let people work a little bit longer on selling stuff.
They loved him, and he loved them. They lived freely. He came to
Rat Lord Billy Hargrove?
Rats have a certain freedom, but they feed on shit. It's a coward's freedom. A Valhalla for the vanquished.
See, it's really weird listening to some of these guys talk. Because they have, like, some clarity with what they're doing. But also not at the same time. Remember to dodge. Yeah, Tim, I tried. And, it didn't work out that great. I was off. Just a little bit. On both of those. Dodging into the heavy attack. And the spear. Alright. Hrothgar. Rat Lord. Enemies panic upon seeing Hrothgar's shiny pate approaching. He takes particular joy in the sound of crunching bones, the skull best of all. The oil employs Hrothgar for any attacks requiring brutality. Okay. Wee. Yeah, no, that wasn't terrible. And I think it's because I really did, like, go all in on my... I knew that I was going to keep with the Way of the Bear stuff and my flail, so I think that also helped immensely. Seven Sisters. The Seven Sisters are a series of chalk cliffs on the south coast of England, often used as a stand-in for the White Cliffs of Dover in films because the White Cliffs really aren't all that white these days, and you're liable to get a fairy wandering into shot. Clawfoss Sands. Unlike most of the beaches in England, what is now called Camber Sands is actually made of sand rather than soul-shredding pebbles. So rare is it to find dunes on these sceptered isle that the British Army used it as a training ground for storming the beaches at Normandy during World War II. Thank you, Sean. We don't need the health thing. I would like to get to this. This is stealth, light resistance, fire resistance. I'm thinking, Tim. I mean, like, I'll bounce to it, but I'm thinking. Let me think. Health, again, not a big thing. Light attack, stun. My stun is great. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. I mean, fire resistance training wouldn't be terrible to have either. Reduces damage of all light incoming light attacks. I do have a problem with that every once in a while. Sorry, I'm really thinking about it. Okay, we'll grab this. And we'll grab this. We'll go up that way. My bag! Whee! I still need more iron. Oh, we did get him. There is probably going to be a synchronization point that we haven't seen way down here. Oh, hey, how much you want to make a bet since there's this, like, little circle here? We'll most likely have to come here at some point for Haytham. I'm just saying. Oh my god, yeah, no shit! There's no way we're going to, like, no way we're going to be finishing it because we haven't even gotten, like, half the order! Hey, my brain's working, Tim. We haven't even gotten half the order yet. Oh my god. I don't know what it is about this game, but it is so easy to forget that the order exists somehow. I don't know. I'm just enjoying my life without the order. Oh my god. Holy shit. Who needs the order when I have such an interesting story and interesting way to spend my life in this land? Oh my god. That's true. If you don't focus, it kind of goes... Yeah, it does go on the wayside very quickly. I don't think they meant for it to be that easy to be forgotten, but holy shit. For an Assassin's Creed game, the focus being on the Templars, which is the Order of Ancients again with this game, it didn't do great. The balance wasn't great. There's just too much. Don't even try to blame the fishing. There's just too much you can do that will just distract you. Fishing not to be blamed. We won't have any fishing to do for a while, though, after I get this last batch of fish. Because the last few that I need, if I'm remembering correctly, are... Well, I guess it's one here. But, I mean, this is power 340. And not there... Well, I guess kind of there. Hold on, I'm trying to find the other name that I'm thinking of. It might be this one. Or that one. But with the power thing, I'm pretty sure we're going to have a little bit of break fishing once I get these last ones. The momentum shifts after you get done with Sigurd. Alright, yeah. I could see that happening. I could see that. Because, I mean, it's very clear that they've been a threat the entire time. It just doesn't seem like they've been the main focus because we're just really concerned about growing the settlement and helping out Sigurd. What do I know? He's missing an arm. I get to write and see, like, the thing is that I can't say that it's another blonde armless twink that I fell in love with over the last like year, because he's not blonde, but he is armless, but he's not a twink. I know, that's why I'm saying, like, I can't say he's exactly like that, but he is suddenly he is added to the list of armless protagonists, or at least like main character, because he's still pretty much a main character. Another one added to the list that's just been growing since last year. One of them does include somebody from Trigon. Oh, Tim, I don't know if you noticed it, but this is actually a thing. A trophy. This is actually a trophy, just pushing already through walls like that. That's a trophy, apparently. Didn't know that. I was kind of looking over the trophies to see what I could find. And that was one of them. Letters smelling of salty dried tears. I didn't think that that could hold a smell. You don't think that you need that? Yeah, it's a thing. It's quite down the list, but it's a thing. Dear Bishop of Canterbury, I send you this letter, for you must be closer to God than King Alfred, who has sent dogs to chase me. That seems about fair. Trust me, Alfred is not looking toward your same God. I have been accused of theft and compromising the Saxon country I love. If you are born different, the world conspires against you to keep you. Please pray for me. But God made me in his image. Jagged forms have a beauty we as mortals are only beginning to understand. They are shattered melodies meant for the mouths of angels. I was hungry and did what I must to share in this earth's bounty of sheep. Now I find myself in a tiny brick castle cage for him to welcome me to heaven. Amen to this cruel world, the distinguished Beowberg. Knowing my luck, I will probably learn about you later on. And I'll probably be stuck coming back here for some reason. That's the other thing that does kind of suck. Wait. Yeah, okay, we're good. That's the other thing that does kind of suck when it comes to this game. Is that... You know, our flighting is probably in this town. Most likely. Is... Unlike in Odyssey, as long as you found the spot where the clue was, it would still give you the clue for the Order members, or the cult members, as they were in Odyssey. In this game, they don't. They don't do that. If you've been in an area where you could find a clue, they make you go back to it anyway. Because you didn't get the clues in the correct order, so no, you don't get to skip. That is something I noticed when we did spend a day going for order
members.
Let's
go put it here.
Not the helmet! Oh, I forgot. Sorry. That was definitely on me. Never mind, we still got a long way to go. Oh, and apparently there's also a trophy for swimming with your horse. Oh, no! No, I didn't want you to jump over everything. Yeah. Thank you. We need the iron. Yeah. We need like 7 pieces of iron so we can upgrade our rations again. Just 7. I didn't mean to break your guys' fence. I thought I was on the road. My bad. Oh, I don't even know what my health's at. I could have grabbed that winter shell, whatever the fuck, the yellow mushroom. I think that building to the right there might be the synchronization point that I was saying that I'm missing on the map. Fuck yeah. I am so smart. There we go. Yeah. That is the one thing that I do also have to give Assassin's Creed credit for, is that they do make pretty easy patterns to the things, like, why things happen in the game, or why certain things look the way they do. They do create really good patterns to help make it a little easier for the person playing the game to kind of figure it out on their own without having their hand held the entire time. I do have to give them credit for that. Is this a town? Hey, we got a raid location, though. I'll have to take care of that soon. I need supplies. Hey, Purple People Eater. Welcome to the stream. Hopefully your day is going well. Hopefully this doesn't fall over. It's not. Thank you for the hydrate. Back to climbing. Oh, come on. So, because I've been replaying Stardew Valley on stream, there might be one. Crap, rip. Okay, since I have been replaying Stardew on stream because of the new update, I have also decided to try going back and getting the trophies on the PS5 that I need. I mean, PlayStation that I need. And I really hate... I had that issue to where I was playing so many Stardew saves at once that I didn't pay attention to the artifacts that I found when I found them on my PlayStation save. So now I'm left with two artifacts that I had a guaranteed spawn of to give to Gunther, and I sold the bastards instead of giving them to Gunther. So now I have to hope that I can find it in an artifact spot, because I didn't give it to Gunther when I should have. And I really don't want to start a whole new Stardew save just to get the artifact thing, and then, oh, actually I can't, because I actually need the artifact thing to be completed in order to find all the star drops. So I've kind of screwed myself, because I was playing so many saves at once that I kept thinking, oh, I already turned that in. Oh, I already turned that in, without checking to make sure I didn't turn it in. You finally made it to your laptop, you think... No! No. I know you probably wrote that while you were listening to me bitch and moan. No, Tim. I have to keep getting trophies so I can stay ahead of you. The main reason that I would be fine with being more friends with people on PlayStation is just so I can keep comparing trophy lists to other people. That'd be, like, the only benefit of being friends with me is how good is your trophy list versus mine. Because I am very heavily into single-player games as of late. But it will be fun, a little bit more fun to play Overwatch tomorrow. Because for anybody who does not remember or does not know, tomorrow's April 1st, April Fool's Day, and Overwatch does have a little bit of fun on April Fool's. So I'm kind of excited to actually do a stream of it this year on April Fool's. Can safely say you will be here for a stream tomorrow. Well, good. Just for April Fool's. Googly eye payload incoming. That's like the only thing we can guarantee. Because they change things up every year when it comes to what certain characters do. I miss 2 years ago Winston's April Fool's Day thing. He was actually powerful. King Vale. Now, Kingly Vale, one of Europe's greatest euphorists. Highly poisonous, yew was a druidic symbol of both death and resurrection. It was sometimes planted in graveyards in the belief that its roots would grow through and seal the eyes of the dead. Sleep tight, everyone! Exactly 2 years ago was amazing, yeah. And we didn't play last year, because we were all one. Oh, April Fool's didn't land on the Overwatch day, and I did not want to play it for stream last year, because... I had a different game that I was playing the day of April Fool's, and I didn't care about changing that out for Overwatch. And then we never played it together. So, yeah. We missed out on last year's fun. So 900 isn't the max. So this year it'll be interesting to actually do it. Now we need 21. Okay. You don't remember what game it was? Fuck. You know, we could probably make a pretty good guess of what it was by going back in my YouTube. But that's about all we can do. Is make a guess by doing that. Is going back in the YouTubes. Okay. Alright. Ooh, didn't mean to do that. Alright, guys. Time to go talk to Boston. Yeah, I really don't remember what game it was. I honestly, with how long this Assassin's Creed adventure has been, it might have been an Assassin's Creed game. It might have been an Assassin's Creed game last year. I don't remember when I started going through this. Did you do Wessex? No. We did not. We're in Suffolk right now. It's just part of Wessex. part of Wessex. No, there is no Wessex. Tim. You're not helping. Essex. No, I did not do Essex. Got it. I did not do Essex. I thought about doing Essex. But then I was like, oh, this show's a settlement thing, so maybe that means I can grow my settlement faster if I go here. So that's the reason why I picked Suffolk, is because it had the opportunity of possibly doing more, having more raid stuff to help upgrade my settlement. And then I found out this is where I needed to go for the story. And just stuck to it. Or Sigurd's story. I should put it that way. Sigurd's story. I know in some way this is still Eivor's story, but this is like the, hello? This is like the, sibling. That's a better way to put it. This is the sibling story. I bet that's an animal. Bet that's an animal I gotta fight. Hold on. While I'm here, I'll just do this. Not close enough. Yep. Alright, that looks like a bowl of fun. With so many to fight later on. Cool. XX would give you an improved RAM for the raid, but it doesn't affect anything for the overall story. Oh, okay. Yeah. That's what I get for thinking that, not for thinking, but for, hoping. Oh, there really is no... Is there no... I think the flighting might be outside of a city for once. Because... Well, that says treehouse shop. That might be something. Because we've been to all the cities and I haven't seen a flighting. Damn. Okay. Why are you making sound? Oh, I bet they'll be flighting right there at the edge of a cliff. All right. Oh shit, take the hide the helmet. Hide the helmet. There we go, hide the helmet. I was ready to just jump right in. Completely forgetting my promise on the helmet.
I'll follow you, Eivor. I will wait for the day I earn a place at your side.
You won't unless you're Tim's. Okay? I think that's in the middle of everything, and if I try to go up above, it's gonna pull me into the thing no matter what. Hey, guys! Long time no see. No, I still won't fuck you. Hey? You guys are also here. Hi.
Eivor, you giant steaming bowl of elk piss. King Oswald sends his regards.
Thank you.
Brother, brother. Or is it the other way around?
It's, good to see you, Eivor. Oh, stop mewing like a heartsick kitten. He's been moping since the wedding.
There'll be time later to reminisce. Are you madmen ready to spill some blood?
After that bastard Red, some nice soft Saxons will make easy meat for my blade.
Yeah. Sure they will. And I do love that I basically said, no, I will not fuck you. And the first thing that happens is him being still lovesick over me. Cool.
Eivor, my second favorite Norse.
I'm glad I at least made it to second.
Must we always drift together on such violent tides?
That is the way of things. Yet the meeting of friends is a glimmer of light in these dark days.
Ella, yeah, sometimes. The optimist, though. It's good to see you both.
I brought no pleasant words, only my blade. Let's see which proves more useful.
I mean, we still could have talked a little bit. You know, a little bit. Yes, game, I know you really want me. Really want me to talk to Bossum, but hold on. Oh, it's on the other side. Charter of Ale Wisdom. The scroll reeks of rotten ale. The south waxen way, the golden glory water charm. Drink 9 mugs of ale and toss 9 more into the muds of the Mian Valley. Then one must guzzle until their loins have no more meaning. Once nude, the palate of the helm is cleansed. Dip your hand in cow dung from the best farms of Crodon. Run nude across the valley of Mian. Drink 9 final goblets of mead and dash moon dust across your empty skin. If darkness has not taken you fully, drink more. For only more from... God. For only from this darkness of the glory water can one refind God. Then one is a South Saxon that can revel in the same glory of the sons of Ayla in 477. When they slay the Britons, and Crodon will be the new seat where the throne shall remain forever. Other than me absolutely butchering every fucking word I read there, what was that?
You wouldn't be the first man to fall asleep on watch.
There we go.
You would be the loudest.
I did not mean to fail you, Guthrum Jarl. It was only for a moment. I was so tired.
As are we all, boy. We marched hard to get here. Still, let's not disappoint me again. You hear?
My Jarl, I'm sorry.
You must be Eivor. I've heard much of you, young one. They say you're something. We'll see.
Okay. Once again, now that I'm done drinking the very, very loud Capri Sun. Sure.
Guthrum Jarl, Saxon Bane and Reaver of the South. I am honored to meet you at last.
Respect where it's due. I like that. Here's hoping you fight as smoothly as you talk.
Oh, trust me, I've worked on both.
Madwoman Fulke, now ensconced in Porchester Fortress. If you wish to crown yourself King of Wessex, Porchester must fall. An alliance here serves us both.
You promised a great army, but you couldn't breach a crone's garden with what you have assembled here.
This is not the sum of my forces. Where are the rest?
Your allies are on their way. We must be patient.
We cannot wait for them. We march as soon as we are able.
With these numbers, are you keen to see Valhalla today?
I'll not sit on my heels while Sigurd rots in that she-dog's care.
We might muster for an attack in the woods east of Porchester. But there are scouts between there and here.
Scouts I can manage. Point me at them and I will blind Fulke's eyes.
One walks the road between Brigsworth and Chichestre. Another on the riverbank, north of Crowley.
This is just giving me busy work until our allies get here.
But I warn you, these are all we know of. There may be more.
A risk we must take. I will find the scouts. You move the men into position near Porchester.
Or not.
That is a rash gamble, Ravenfeeder. If we are spotted, we will be vulnerable.
If you want victory, come now or not at all. Every hour we waste could be Sigurd's last.
You had better be all they promised.
That didn't... though as great as I'd hoped. So I also have a little bit of a question. Would I have gotten more allies to show up if I...
from all over the land.
Like these two fine fellows. Brother and Broder, was it?
Careful, Saxon. We're here for the killing, not to make friends.
You're here to make friends. Anyway. I thought that, would I have had more people around if I would have went to more? Or is it just, like, the story beat alliances that would have showed up here. That'd be my other, that would be my only other question, is if I would have done more alliances before doing this, if more would have been here or not. And then it just really didn't matter. Because I feel like it doesn't matter. It would have been what... I'm not reading that. It would have been just, what I did during the sibling story. No. No. Yes. Yeah. Yes, I'm going to disturb you guys again. Essex was the only that would have made a difference. Oh. Well, you know, if only the game would have given me a hint at like that. But only for cutscenes. No real difference. Okay. Oh, I bet I see how I have to do it. Figuring it out. And then the fact that I have to climb the wall, though. Just the right way. Okay. Finally free. Inventory. Oh, I the reason why I don't care anymore about the Rigasaur whatever story is because it takes so long to read through those pages that I got tired of reading through them off stream, so I have no idea what's going on in that story. Guthrum was one of the most prominent leaders of the Great Heathen Army. After taking land in Mercia and Northumbria, Guthrum turned his ambitions to Wessex, where he became King Alfred's most persistent enemy. A skillful tactician, as well as a fearsome warrior in his own right, Guthrum exemplified the hit-and-run guerrilla warfare mentality of the invaders, which allowed them to win so many early victories against the slower, more disorganized Anglo-Saxon fears. Through a combination of politicking, ransom, and surprise attacks, Guthrum kept his enemies divided, while bit by bit, he conquered their lands. Good job. Ramby says something down the lines of more regions will help, but it's entirely missable based on what you click on at the table. Well, isn't that great?
Control
isn't
yourself.
That fucking great? Oh, I meant to talk to those guys. I don't think it's going to be anything, like, super important, but I did mean to talk to them again since they have
Basim,
a speak bubble.
Good to find you here. What news do you have?
Fulke remains at Porchester. Just as we suspected. And as of 3 days ago, Sigurd was with her. Alive.
That is the best news we could hope for. And how are you?
I am well. And keen to see my old friend again.
I mean, he won't look at me, so maybe having this helmet on is not helping, because Basim won't even look at me. Hello, Ambrose. Welcome back to the stream as well. Hopefully your day's going good.
Guthrum Jarl. Your second Soma talked often of you and your conquests.
Who was it?
They are all one in my memory. A single great battle that stretches from my first breath to the end of this sentence.
Who was your Soma?
It sounds glorious. A living Valhalla.
Perhaps it does. But what happens when all the dead wear the same face and their pleas become a senseless blare? Where did Torsten die? On a field or in a marsh? We were close as brothers once, yet I don't recall where or when.
You have suffered much. You are not as fierce as I expected. Why did you come here?
You wear the scars of battle, and not only on your skin.
The needle of loss becomes blunt once you have been pierced enough. But enough of that.
Okay. Happy Trans Day of Visibility? Yeah! Happy Trans Day! Oh, excuse me. Alright, or you could push me into the corner for pets. Oh... It kind of works. Kind of. But yeah, happy transit. Okay, please, let me out. Let me out. Let me out. I need to be free. Was there one closer to us? No. There is not. Not closer than what I saw. It's probably too soon to be doing that. Looks like a possible.
You said there would be a scout on this hill.
Yeah, you mean like the three people that are just sitting there? Well, that didn't do any damage to them.
I smell blood on the air.
That kind of sucks. That's if they were even the one that I had to go for. Might not have even been that.
Hold there.
Why are you so dedicated on this, buddy?
Hey!
He was really dedicated on that. Okay, so that wasn't the one. How about you? Nope, not him either.
Show me what lies ahead.
Man, I really try to find it on my own, but it never works out great. Never does.
Death is close. Did someone find the scout before me?
Maybe. Oh my goodness gracious. Okay, give me like a second to get up, you fuckers. Fucking love being just stuck in an animation that I can't get out of. Still can't figure out a wild animals thing is always gonna get me. I went around to try to avoid
slain by wolves.
Yeah, I tried to avoid the wolves, but they wanted to attack, so whatever. Whatever. It's not all that smart. Six, this one. Hey-ya! Oh, that's a mushroom. It's about to get a little exciting if that ended up being a fighting thing. I've let go of the analog stick twice and you still didn't stop running, so that is not my fault.
A scout patrol. A scout patrols the riverbank north of Crowley. Fulke scout.
I might have also seen that that was something that I needed to do too as a trophy.
I should show this to Basim once I've dealt with the others.
Whee! So I snagged one while I could. You learn a lot when you just look through the trophy list. You missed what it was. Doing an assassination off horseback. And it worked exactly like I thought it was gonna work too. So it made it super easy to get it done. Sorry you missed anything you might have said to me because you were dealing with Facebook bullshit. That's alright. I pretty much just said happy Trans Day back. Oh, and then of course, you know, welcomed you into the stream. Also said, hopefully your day is going well. The usual stuff. And I got, but I didn't break any group rules, so you're trying to contact mods. Yeah, that sounds about right for Facebook. That Stretch sounds about right. Sinning. They get real. It's most likely just somebody being a little bitch. That's how it goes. See, it's so nice to be able to kill things with my bow. It's so pleasant. Yeah. I did see that that was some of the problems with the, I did see that that was a problem with the recent, That was gonna be a problem because of people just being what they were. A scout. Oh. Beep, 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 beep.
Why all the sights die?
Because a day was picked, a day that doesn't change depending on, you know, the trans visibility day was picked to be the same day every year. Easter is based on, the moon cycles or whatever. I don't know. I don't know the particular ways of how it goes. But, so that's why it changes every year. And, of course, there's gonna be people that are gonna be pissed about it. Fulke's orders. Plans for the reinforcement of Portia-shire. That's not even anything that big. That's all it is. It's just plans for reinforcements. Yeah, people suck. That's about it. That pretty much solves everything right there. It's just that people suck. Okay. Or my horse doesn't have to come to my whistle. Thank you. I did all, you know, Tim, even if I didn't choose Suffolk for the settlement thing, now that I'm thinking about it, I don't think I would have chose Essex because the reward for Essex was just saying silver. I probably would have done the supply thing, which is something further north. Where am I going?
Cast about this land, my friend.
That's where I'm going. So I probably wouldn't have done Essex, like, anytime soon. Just because by the rewards thing in the map, it was basically just saying silver was the main thing you'd get from it. And seeing as I don't need silver, that's why it didn't happen. What's up?
Scouts are dead, and you're safely encamped. I told you this would work.
Time will tell.
Any eye that saw you has been dimmed by death.
You are not short on confidence. That much is clear.
Yes, I have lots of confidence. You would do every region still for order stuff and more story. Well, and that's the other thing is that, like, I don't know where the sibling story is until you click on it, since I haven't played it before. I wouldn't know until I clicked on it. And yes, when I heard that it was more of Sigurd's story right away, I should have backed out and probably did a different region. But I ended up just sticking with it. My confidence... I wish I could say I could do that with every decision ever made in an RPG. Is I make a decision and I'm like, I'm sticking to it. I wish I had that. And I don't. Alright, so my confidence is well-founded. It was a calculated risk. I have something more urgent to share. Well, I kind of do have something more urgent to share. Yeah.
I found something of interest on one of the scouts. Fulke has news of Croindonin's fall. She's gathering men and supplies, perhaps to weather a siege.
If she is allowed to dig in at Porchester, it might be months before we can get Sigurd out.
Do you still say I am reckless in my haste, Guthrum?
Saxons! Saxons from the west!
I say your haste has put us squarely in the shit.
Yeah, seems about right. You're the same way, you second guess a lot
of
stuff.
Was forewarned. There must have been more scouts than we knew of.
What's done is done. Save your breath for the fight.
I mean, I technically killed, like, everybody I came across. Well, there we go. I finally hit an ally. I thought it couldn't happen, and here we are. It can.
Eivor, this mess is of your making.
We kill them here, or behind the walls of Portchester. Either way, they die.
That's the way, Eivor. And for Odin!
Like, for the most part, I can just walk up and hit them with one hit.
They're giving ground! Push them back!
The tide turns for us!
Ooh! Big man! Big man came in hot.
Out of my way. Keep up, you
shit. I did it wrong. It's alright. I may not be able to see you, but I can guarantee I still hit you.
We watch each other's backs. Leave it to me.
Really? Coward. It was interesting to finally see him throw somebody else, though.
The Saxons falter!
Run them down! Trample them into the mud!
Now, to be fair, one of the main reasons why the battling is going so nice for me right now is because I am still quite overpowered for this region. Alright, the other dude wasn't close enough. Come on, guys! Oh, okay. Oh, you're here. I can't see. I was put in a really bad situation for not being able to see. Alright, you fell. I think I just need to kill one more person and it might be done. Nope. I might need to kill one more bigger person and we might be done. I was about to say, that little bit is sure taking a while.
Back, you dogs! Back to Porchester!
They flee like rabbits.
Then we chase them like hounds. That ugly bastard's head is mine.
How about none of you fight him? No. How about I fight him?
Leave him. The day's already won.
No. I fight him. Anybody who fights the big bads that's not me ends up getting hurt or killed. Yeah, that's going as great as I fucking thought. Cool. Hey.
Death has found you, Saxon.
What was that dance, my dude?
Soon enough.
Too soon.
Is it for that withered bag of skin you fight? For Sigurd the Sickly?
If Sigurd dies today, I will find your corpse and piss on it.
Dude, this guy doesn't even get that much time to shit on me because of all the leveling up I've done compared to him. Man, that's a shame. Real shame.
You bear your false deities like
yeah, if only they
listened
to me.
But you know nothing of those who truly decide our fate.
I don't care. Your fate today, Saxon.
I am ready for my final journey. Let me see what lies beyond.
You thinking you're gonna see Juno? With pleasure? Ooh, take a message to Fulke? Ooh. Honestly, I don't see a reason to let him take a message back to Fulke because the champion not returning is enough of a message in my mind. Especially since we are going to attack it anyway. And honestly, I'd rather not fight this guy again if I've already beat him here. And he did kill... there's a very good chance that he killed Broder and Brother. So sure.
When you see your god, tell him I sent you.
Fake choice. Fight him now or fight him later. Yeah, and I already fought him, so why would I want to fight him again? Oh, well, it looks like Brother died.
He's dead, Eivor. No breath within him. Gods, I've never seen the raucous bastard so quiet.
Well, let's...
You are wounded, Brother. Let me bear your brother to the camp.
Yeah, if only you would have listened to me when I said leave him. I know how it is.
He was always quicker than me. Beat me out of the womb by mere moments.
Mm-hmm.
Now he has beat me to Valhalla. Even in death, he had to be first. Need you
here. Seems so. Sorry, my man. I'll grab that silver real quick. Or that doll. I think he is done talking to me, so I'm gonna eat that.
Thor lends me strength.
You almost put him on the bed, Eivor.
Reckless
almost.
Stripling. I warned you the risk was too great.
Peace, Guthrum. It is Fulke who merits your wrath, not Eivor.
You have not seen the half of my wrath. How many of my men now lie dead on account of this glory hoarder?
I bear the blame for that. No one made you come. It is over. Move on.
Many have died. My friend here among them. The fault is mine. Knowing that is shame enough.
Small comfort that is to the dead.
I mean, it's supposed to be what comfort toward here? You.
Uber,
ah!
Soma, you come at a
oh,
black
Soma!
Hour.
That's what he meant by Soma.
Blades. Most a pity.
I hope to take Porchester with this one. But Fulk is forewarned now. I have no more appetite for this. I will go west.
Go then. But know you leave me in a time of need.
What you need is to swallow your pride, raven feeder. Listen to wiser heads than yours.
Eivor?
You know, he's kind of got a point. You know what? I like calm heads.
Guthrum Saxon Bane, if you wish to speak your peace.
You want your Jarl back? You must be cold as frost. Bravery is your enemy as often as your friend. We do not dash ourselves against hopeless courses. We arrive unexpected, strike swift, gather your allies, pick your moment. Then, and only then, you crush them. You can triumph yet. Go with the wisdom of Odin, power of Thor, the wit of Freya.
We've been ignoring Odin's advice for a while now. But clearly I'm not going to have him as an ally. Which is fine.
Guthrum spoke.
My hair is bothering me.
But there is wisdom in what he says.
Of course there's wisdom. I do agree.
I heard and heeded.
Thanks for the hydrate, purple people leader.
I'm not too proud to admit my mistake.
Then there is wisdom in you as well.
We will wait for our allies.
I mean, I spent a whole...
Until then, we have
many... I spent a whole 3 games playing Commander Shepard. I feel like I should have some wisdom when it comes to battle.
First, we need a new camp.
Thank you for the posture check
Saxons
as well.
The Saxons think we have retreated, but we will draw even closer. Here.
Arrive unexpected.
Erke, Stowe, right there ahead of me. Together we'll bring them down.
It brings me no pleasure to fight my own people. But a debt is a debt. We will leave immediately.
Besides, they're men of Wessex, Alfred's folk, no brothers of yours.
After that, we should strike at Fulke's supplies all across Suffolk.
Yes. If she is allowed to dig in at Porchester, we will lose our chance to rescue Sigurd.
The letter
exactly.
I found on the scout mentioned Bridgeworth, Guildford, and Crowley.
They produce weapons in Crowley, food in Guildford. Bridgeworth is a stronghold. Many Saxon swords there.
Uber, I need your axe arm at Guildford. Soma, you and your men will aid me in Crowley.
Count on us.
I will go to Bridgeworth and take a measure of things there.
Good. I'll join you after I've dealt with the Saxon camp.
A lion's heart and a crow's cunning. Guthrum judged you too swiftly.
We have work to do. Let's
you
be
know,
about it.
I was also meant to say that, but I know I would not have thought all that myself. But we're trying.
Soma and Uba, I apologize. I would have liked to offer better welcome after your long journey.
I'm only sorry we could not be here sooner.
We'll need a short while to organize the men. Then we'll set off as soon as we're able.
Uba Regnason, it puts me at ease to see you here. Welcome.
Welcome, welcome.
Avon Wolfkiss tempts me with a swipe at Wessex. Who am I to resist?
Here we might finish the work your father began a decade back. Are you ready?
More than ready. I am hungry.
Nice. I love having good allies.
Now here is a welcome face, Soma. How fares Grendebridge?
We thrive, just as we did our first year. And I have you to thank for that.
The risk I took was far less than you're taking now. I thank you for heeding my call.
An oath is an oath, Eivor. Silver gilded and iron clad.
Thank you! Now time to go talk to the sad one.
What I would give to be there when he appears in Odin's hall. Old One Eye will have his hands full tonight. But I cannot let my brother lie forgotten in unknown soil. I must take him home. Bury him with what finery I can muster.
I understand. May Freya watch your way, brother. Until we meet again.
Aye. Until then.
Yep, that's fair. That's fair. This man's talking to himself. Cool. Always a good sign. Ooh, too much over. Oh, we're working over here. I want the stealth damage. Even though I haven't really had a trouble... I haven't had any trouble with any of the stealth kills that I've been doing. I have been getting them... They've all been happening very easily. Granted, I took away the quick time event for it. But I haven't had any issues of killing anybody stealthily that I've chosen to kill stealthily.
Hey-ya!
You know, not keeping Guthrum as an ally is not too much of a shock, because I haven't been able to prove myself all that much to him yet. Like, I've been able to prove myself to everybody else. So, it makes a lot of sense. Oops, get back down. Thank you. As to why he wouldn't stick around when, one idea went south. I may be also a little crazy on trying to get my brother back. They were talking to each other, and I interrupted them. What's up?
Erke, Stow, ready to attack.
I
have reservations.
Didn't think this would be much of a cutscene.
Sparrowheart has reservations.
Though Mercia wars often with Wessex, these people are Christians. Perhaps I can talk to them to avert more bloodshed.
We will try it your way, Stow. We would lose the element of surprise. I will go in alone. Oh boy. We would lose the element of surprise. But I kind of feel like I shouldn't just deny Stow what he wants to try. Because it's not like, I mean, like, I'm also afraid of losing somebody else, but this does kind of feel like I could lose people no matter what I end up choosing anyway. Because it just seems like one of those tipping points in the story that I may lose more than just brother here. Ho! Fuck it.
You know the people of this isle better than I, Stow. I trust you.
Thank you, Eivor. I will do what I can.
I gotta put my trust in Stell again. I gotta do it.
Brave soldiers.
Fuck.
My name is Stow, Reeve of London. And this Dane at my side is Reeve Erke.
We're stuck with the rabbit helmet.
He is my partner in London. Together, we see that justice is done. But more, he is my friend. In London, we live in harmony with the Danes. So could you. But your king does not share our philosophy. Alfred bleeds his land dry. Works you all to the bone for a needless war. Now he wants you to die for it. So I beg you, in God's name, walk away from this camp. I will find you new and worthy employment in London. You are good men and true. I would not want this day to be your last.
The helmets.
This one's right. The Danes are here to stay, like it or not. What good's dying now?
Don't be a lackwit. Soon as you drop your swords, they'll murder us.
That's no heathen talking. He's a Saxon. I, for one, believe him.
Come on, lads. It's a new life in London for us.
New life in London!
Dying here in the mud.
Fuck
we'll
yes!
Deal with you traitors later.
All right, never mind. Some of them went.
The rest of you, attack!
Damn it,
friend, but now we do things my way.
We didn't kill as many as what he was afraid of doing. Hey, hold on. Just a second. Thank you. I know it's kind of useless now because we are already past the important stuff, but you know what? I'm making an effort. Damn. You have a freaking big shield. Anyway, yes, that still went better because we didn't kill all of them. Which is definitely something that Stow wanted more. He wanted to limit the amount of bloodshed, and we limited it. We really did. Alright. Really? That counted as you hitting me from all the way over there? Ah! his back turned to me. That's pretty much what I was... You know what? We probably saved, like, two people. To be fair, I think we saved two people. That's not a lot. But we still saved some, and I gave Stowe his chance to... to have the outcome that he wanted to have. Alright, or too soon? Too soon. I'm impatient. I'm not impatient. It was three? Well, you know what? Three's better than nothing.
The camp is ours!
That wasn't so hard, was it, Stowe?
Even one man's death is too many.
Now I must see about destroying Fulke's supplies.
Is there something up there? Yep, there is. There's indeed something up there.
Okay. Did we do the right thing here?
At least at home we have the law to guide us. Out here.
And I've lost my train of thought. Yeah.
At least at home we have the law to guide us.
He's gonna be saying that line a lot until I'm done going in and out.
At least at home we have the law to guide us. Out here, the only rule is the sword.
Listen, you saved three men's lives. Like, that is a lot compared to... Three men compared to, you know, like, maybe the 10 behind us is still a decent number. Because no matter what happens is that we were fighting up against people that, like, fully believe in, Alfred
I feel great.
And his choices, even though his choices are not... for the good of everybody in the kingdom. I mean, like, I'm glad. I am super glad I went Stowe's way. Alright. Put the helmet back on, and then don't trust anything. Anytime I'm talking with one of my friends, we just have to take the helmet off. That's what it's boiling down to. We have to keep taking it on and off. Where is my inventory that is new and bothering me? Is it in the weapon? Never mind. Okay, so this is burn the grains. Okay, so Bossum is still last at least, so we'll go to Uba. We'll just go in order to Uba. That's actually pretty close. I do want to go check out this treehouse shop, though, real quick, just to see if this is a world event or possibly a flighting. Since we're close. I say close, even though it's 500 meters away. I just want to know. Because flighting is so important. I was about to say, it's the only spot that seemed like, since there wasn't one in any of the towns, it's the only spot that seemed like it could be flighting for not being in a town. Nope, it's a world event. I gave it a shot. Did you see the Eivor bobblehead? No. I did not. At it? Like, is it in here? Or is it in the bat in my bag? Did I miss it in my bag? Going slow. Also, how the fuck do I release these fireflies? I need to release them for a thing. Ugh. it is in the helmets? It didn't look like it was. Oh. Oh my God in heaven. Oh, hold on. Oh, Jesus. I mean, it's fair that it's just as big. Oh my God. No, I did not see that. I kind of thought it was just a regular helmet. Jesus. Alright, back to the rabbit, though. I bet that one is more for the April Fool's thing. I'm pretty sure that's more for the April Fool's part of this weekend. The Eivor bobblehead, compared to the rabid one. I don't know what hairstyle they gave Eivor for it. It seemed a little off compared to what I have normally. Excuse me, not close enough.
All is ready.
We're a town of farmers and shepherds.
I didn't do it again.
This place bristles
shit.
With swords. One of them is a thane by his dress. Serious man with him too. Went into the longhouse.
If we take
I
care,
think we'll be okay
we
though because I put on my hood
while we burn the grain silos.
Was that a jest? Bring them on. Been too long since I met a Saxon warrior worth half a shit.
Okay, let me just make sure that if the hood comes off, this does not bother us. Okay. Excuse me, people. Okay, that did work. I was like, did that not work? Hello? How many silos are there gonna be? Oh, I see another one right there. Oh, is there a group of monks that I can hide in? That is something else. That I gotta do too is hide in a group of monks. I don't think we have a group of monks to coerce though. I can think of a decent place for the monk thing. It's definitely not here. So at least I have a place to go. Okay, excuse me, people. All right. I said, excuse me. I love that that does not count as a civilian casualty. Mind you, that did not count as a civilian casualty. Once the torch left my hand, it was up to them.
It's hard to be quiet with you complaining.
Sorry, looks like another silo. Oh wow, that set off a lot faster. Ooh, boy!
What do you see?
Whenever Sunin wants to zoom in. Okay, so Sunin can't see the silos, which is not ideal. Well, I mean, he can't see them lit up blue, which would be a lot easier for me to spot. Excuse me, sheep. The damn bow away before they screw us up. Oh, there's one.
It is not our way. We are not hiding like field mice. We're stalking like lynxes.
Can we not just kill a lot of them?
Do it my way first.
Please, I worked so hard on this. I actually worked pretty hard on doing this without causing a stir. I'd like to finish it for once. Oh. Got it. Saw it! Oh, it's marked now, too. After I already did that. I do love that it seems like no matter who I'm with, there's always going to be somebody complaining about me doing it one way or another. I also love the fact that that counts as burning the silo, just by throwing a torch on the side of the building. We win! Yeah, Uba's not near me anymore, so okay. We're good, we got it. Easy peasy. Okay, now to speak to Soma. Do a little bit more of this. She's just claiming the stealth thing up here. Light attack damage, stun. Stun, way of the bear. Great sword, bearded axe. Critical. Let me go up here first. Because this is where Way the Bear is. We'll go up there first. Okay. Our next one is very, very far away. No, it's going pretty great, though. Things are going smooth. No. I know I could have used my horse, but I'm good. I guess I'm just gonna have to find my flighting in this region. Off stream.
Soma, what is happening here?
Bandits. Besides you kind of crappily hiding in a bush.
Suffix to fill their pockets.
Odin smiles on us today.
Let us make sure this place is burned to the ground. Fulke will get no more weapons from here.
We could charge in while they are distracted, but it would be safer to use fire arrows.
Use the archers.
Burn them from afar. Watch them scatter like cats.
A sound decision. I agree.
Archers! Take your positions!
The Saxons will attack Soma and her men.
When they see us, they will charge. We must defend the men.
Oh, okay. Oh, so it's kind of like... Are we waiting? What are we doing? Oh, okay.
Stand fast, Eivor. Protect the archer!
They will not get past me.
Can't hold out.
They are getting past me. I just want to point that out. They are getting past me.
Hell, thank you!
Saxons! You're patted down like weeds!
Save your energy, Eivor! There may be more yet!
Oh, hey, how you doing? Hey, how you doing? I mean, thankfully they're not going past us. I kind of hope it stays that way. Plenty. Plenty.
Our numbers dwindle! We are winning!
Do not falter now, Soma!
Never!
Soma!
Alright. I don't know if that was one of their archers from afar, or... He attacked without having an animation to attack, but it wasn't great. Okay, got him. Why did we lose some progress with the fire of Crawley being burned exactly? Why? Okay, we got it back. Interesting. We're losing it again? What is happening here?
Enough! Crowley dances with hard chunks. Soon it will be ashes.
Archer! Lower your bows and return to camp!
Okay, so it did get completed, even though it kept going back and forth. Thanks, game?
Forges have been destroyed. No more weapons will be made here.
Well fought, Eivor. My archers and I will return to camp and await your further orders.
Okay. That was too soon. That was way too late. Missed it. I think it's because these guys didn't come attack us like they were supposed to. I think that's why I kept going back and forth. Would be my guess. Alright. Let's go to the next one, which is Bossum! Oh, that's because I'm in the bad place. And now I'm free. So we can travel.